So in this video, I'm going to go out and shoot a roll of medium format film through my Mamiya C330 TLR. I'm going to come home, develop it and scan it and kind of tinker with it in Lightroom, all within a relatively short time frame, and just kind of show you what I do step by step. This video basically came about because I shared a picture on my Instagram a few days ago, and I mentioned, you know, it felt good to be just shooting for the fun of it and not for the sake of doing a video. And I also mentioned that I shot it, developed it and scanned it the same day. And I actually had a few people message me on Instagram just saying they'd love to see my process for doing like same day developing and scanning. So even though I was out shooting for the sake of it to not make a video, I've now ended up making a video out of it because a few people asked me to, and I don't mind. You know, I've got loads of ideas for videos on the back burner at the moment just because we're in lockdown and they all involve meeting up with other people and stuff, so I can't do it at the moment. So I thought, why the heck not? So I'm going to go out for a little walk with my family with my Mamiya C330 TLR. It's a bit overcast at the moment, so I'm going to put a roll of black and white Ilford HP5 through it. It's a bit easier to develop as well, obviously black and white. I'm going to come home, develop it, wait for it to dry, scan it, and then edit it a little bit and post it to Instagram and just show you kind of along the way what I do. I mean, one of the main annoyances of shooting film, if you don't develop yourself, is actually having to wait to get those scans back from the lab. And although, you know, doing it yourself can cause other issues if you're not used to what you're doing and whatnot, I think over time when you get used to it and you learn exactly what it is you need to be doing, it's a much quicker and, in my opinion, much more enjoyable experience.
Can it be that you're here with me? Let's start writing our own history. Let's take this road, oh, this winding, winding road. Let's just take the long way home. Just keep going round, going round. You've got me running in circles. I can't keep both feet on the ground. Let's just keep spinning, spinning, spinning. Just keep going round, going round.
Yeah, can I just get a bag of donuts, please? Thank you. Oh, lovely, thank you. Donuts. Right, so we go eat them.
Nothing but sunshine, sunshine and happiness are all that's around us now. And I haven't felt, oh, I haven't felt, haven't felt like this for a long, long time. Just keep going round, going round. You've got me running in circles. I can't keep both feet on the ground. Let's just wake keep up, spinning, up, spinning, up. Spinning.
Bye, bye. Okay, so I just got back from the walk and I'm literally just going to develop the roll of black and white now, show you kind of everything step by step. I've done a video about this before with colour film where I kind of walked you through it in greater detail. This is when I kind of started to get back into YouTube and I got my wife to do it, so I'll link that above if you kind of want to know more about how to load the film onto the reels and stuff like that. But this is just going to be super quick, going to show you how I do it, and then I'll show you how I scan it later once it's dry. Okay, so at the moment the black and white developer I'm using is Ilfocell 3 by Ilford, and I just got this come in a free pack, so you've got the developer, the stop and the fixer all in one pack for I think it was like 25 quid 30 quid. So I've just got to mix the chemicals quickly with water. So I start with the developer. You can do it at 1 to 9 or 1 to 14, so I'll just do it at 1 to 14. So obviously I'm making up 600 milliliters, So 600 divided by 14, 42.85. So I want 42, which is right. Pour it into the larger one and fill it up with water up to 600 milliliters. There. So that is actually, give it a mix, good to go. Now you want this to be 20 degrees. My tap, it always seems to come out about 18. So I will leave that to warm up. Obviously I haven't loaded the film or anything. This is why I do the mixing first, so it's got time to come to room temperature. Then I'll make the stop. See, that's 19 to 1. So 600 divided by 19, 31.5789474. We'll go for 32. Always rinse as well, because that's had developer in it, obviously. So we'll go for 32 milliliters. Pour into that. Fill it up to 600 milliliters. Now, because I've only got two of the big ones, I then pour this just into a glass jug, which I use specifically for developing. So that's good to go. And what I'll do when I place them by the sink is I'll place them in order, so I know I've got developer, then I need the stop, then I need the fix. In my opinion, with black and white, like, it doesn't, nothing has to be as precise, nothing has to be as perfect as what it does with colour film, so it's definitely like one of the easiest ones to start with if you're thinking about getting into developing yourself. So fix, we've got 1 to 9 is what I'm doing it at, so 600 divided by 9 is about 66.66667. So we'll go 67. So there, fill that up to 600. That's my chemicals, good to go. And you want this to be kind of room temperature, about 20 degrees. So whilst that is coming to room temperature, I will load the film into the tank. So, got the tank ready to go. Make sure everything's nice and dry. And I've got the reel in here. I've got a few of these already set up for 120, obviously. So I just need to get the film out of the camera, obviously make sure it's fully wound. This will already be fully wound, just make sure that it is fully wound. Out comes the film. Obviously if I was sending it off to a lab, I would then, you know, stick it down, lick it, make sure it was safe, write my exposure on there if I had pushed it or whatnot. But that's done, get the camera out of the way. Yeah, so I'm using a change bag because obviously I don't have the luxury of having a dark room, unfortunately, where I live in at the moment, so I just change everything in the change bag. So just pour literally everything in the bag that you're going to need. I'm not going to need that lid in the bag. Zip it up to protect it from the light. And yeah, get your arms in there. So again, I have done a video of this before talking you through. If you're using the change bag and you really don't know how to get the film onto the reel, I've done a video before of how to develop colour film from home, and I walk you through every step of the way in that one, how you actually get the film off of the spool and onto the reel. But luckily for me, I'm a pro now, aren't I? He says. Here we go. Pop in the tank. On goes the lid. So now no light can get into the tank. And hey presto, film's in there. Rubbish goes in the bin. So obviously once you've developed certain films before, you start to get an understanding of how long they need to be developed for and stuff like that. Especially with black and white films, it's all dependent on what developer you're using, what dilution you're using for that developer, what you rated the film at, etc., etc. So obviously if you don't know, there's a website called Massive Development Chart, which you can go to and type in what film you used, what developer you used and stuff, and it will tell you. And they've actually got a an app for iPhone and Android, which I use, which is just called, it says DevIt, but it means develop it. So you can just go to that app. You can literally click it. Obviously, you can save certain things so you can come back to them, but you can just click on it and say I'm shooting HP5 and I rated it. Well, I'll tell you what, I shot, I'm developing with Ilfasol. So there we go. So straight away, HP5, Ilfasol, and I've the dilution I'm doing is 1 to 14, and it's come up straight away. HP5. Rated at 400, which is what I rated at in Ilfasol at 1 to 14. So I can click develop it, and it's telling me I need to do it for 11 minutes, agitate every 60 seconds, stop bar for 1 minute, and the fixed bar for 3 minutes, agitate every 6 seconds. So 60 seconds, so I'll do that. Okay, so obviously we will start with the developer, and that goes in for 11 minutes. So if we click start on this app, that will actually then give us the time limit as it counts down. So that's started. The lid on, make sure it's nice and airtight, and there we wait. So because we're agitating it every 60 seconds, we're just keeping an eye on the timer, and every time it gets to another minute, we agitate it for 10 seconds. Coming up to a minute, so now we agitate. There we go. And we'll literally just repeat this process for 11 minutes, so it'll be 10 agitations. Okay, so next is the stop for 1 minute. You should probably wear gloves for this, but I just try to avoid getting it on my hands. I don't actually know if you're supposed to agitate it, but usually halfway through I just give it a little bit of a mix. And then after that, obviously, is the fix for 3 minutes. And this is 3 minutes agitate every 60 seconds for 10 seconds, so you'll agitate it twice. Excuse the jingle bells, because for some reason we're putting up Christmas decorations mid-November. So yeah, so as long as everything was done correctly, which it should have been, then the photo should all be developed. Voila. Okay, so my film is dry, so I am now going to scan it. So I've literally just got a tripod on the table, got my camera on the tripod, I've got the Fuji XF 16mm macro lens, I've got my Kaiser slim light plano LED light panel, and I've masked off any of the light that I don't need, so all the sides and that section, and just left enough of a space for the essential film holder. So if you're doing any DSLR scanning, this is hands down probably the best item that I've used for DSLR scanning. It's called the Essential Film Holder. I'll link it below in the comments, but it does 35 and 120 film, and it just makes it super, super easy. Literally just slide your film in like so. Okay, so get it in. Tighten it up till you feel the bite, just so it's nice and secure and flat, and then line it up under the camera. So in order to get my camera flat or level, I just use my phone app, and within all iPhones there's an app called Measure, and within that Measure app there's also a level. So I literally just place it on top of the camera. There you go. You know it's level because it goes lovely bright green colour. So I know that the camera is now level, so now it's a case of lining it up with the screen. Okay, so obviously you want to do this in complete darkness, so there is no extra lights coming from any other light source apart from the light panel. This is literally all you want to be seeing. The light from the back of your camera and the light from the light panel. On the back of the camera, don't know if you can see that, you just want to be seeing your frame shot. Settings wise, F8, and then I have my ISO as low as possible, 160. And then my shutter speed, you just want to get it to look as right as possible, nice and bright but not overblown. And I think at the moment I've got it on half a second. Best thing to do is either use a like a cable release or put on a self timer. So I just put on a self timer for 2 seconds, and once the timer's on, you can take the pictures. So you take a picture and then just move the film along to the next shot. Picture taken, next shot. So I've now scanned all of those images from that roll of film. I've put the SD card into my MacBook and I've loaded the images directly into Lightroom. So I'm going to do a screen record now and just show you quickly how I convert them using Negative Lab Pro and just what little tweaks I make. And if you've made it this far, well done. So here's all the 12 images as they are photoed. So just directly into Lightroom as they are. What I would do first of all, especially if I'm just doing one roll of film, is I would crop them all first. So because obviously this was taken with the TLR, they're all 6x6, so I'd crop them one by one. And yeah, I'd just go in quickly and I'd crop them all kind of how I want them. And you know, maybe straighten them up, neaten them up a little bit. Just as a rough kind of start, I'd do that to all of them. I won't make you watch me do this for every image, but just so you get an idea, I'll go through and I will do this for all of the images first and foremost. Okay, so once they're all cropped to how I want them, I'll then go Command All, select all of them, and then Control N brings up Negative Lab Pro. So I've got my settings already saved for how I like black and white. So basically I've kind of got settings, you know, in my head that how I like my black and whites to look and how I want my colors to look and stuff like that. So I've got them all saved for black and white, so I can just click Convert 12 negatives. And obviously it will take a little bit of time because it's doing all 12, but it will just convert them all in one go, so then I can look through them and see if there's any other tweaks I want to make. Okay, so as you can see, that's now all 12 converted. What I will also do, I mean, usually I'd go through and look through them quickly and make sure they're cropped okay and stuff like that, but just for the sake of this video, I'm going to make a copy of all of them, and I usually add it to a subfolder. Okay, so that's now done. So now I've got all the converted TIFF files. You can literally click on this negatives and it will show the positives that is created from them. So I can click on that and now it's now just going to show me all of the positive files, all the converted ones ready for me to edit in Lightroom and make any tweaks that I do want to make to them. So, I mean, with colour, obviously I'm a little bit more picky. But with black and white it's so much easier because you kind of you want to get the same sort of vibe going on with all the images, and I'll probably edit them all very very similar anyway. So again, I'm going to kind of do this for the sake of being speedy, but also for the sake of showing you how easy it is. I'm going to select all of them. What I would like to do with most of my black and white is I'll add like a little vignette into it, especially with that TLR. I find it just sort of helps the black and white images pop a little bit more. I'll probably add a bit of contrast, reduce the highlights a bit, lift the shadows a little bit, drop the blacks a bit, bring in a little bit of texture, a little bit of dehaze, and then I'd sharpen the image probably up to about 20, no more than that. And that is pretty much it. And then I just go through all the images individually and just make sort of like various tweaks, brighten that up a bit. I think that one needs a bit more contrast. I'm doing it quick for the sake of the video, but just to kind of show you, I'll bring the shadows up in that one. A bit more contrast again. And I'd obviously go through them and straighten them up. But this is just to kind of show you how quickly that this can be done, you know, same day as well. Like, I'm knackered, I didn't want to finish this video today, but I just wanted to kind of show you that, you know, how easy it is to go out, shoot a roll of film, come home, develop it, scan it, fiddle with the files in Lightroom, get them looking how you want to get them to look, and, you know, be able to share them online or send them off for printing and stuff like that if you just want to print from the digital files. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Go through, tweak them a little bit. Black and white are quite easy to deal with, quite easy to manage, and I'm quite happy with all of them as they are. But yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching. Hopefully you made it all the way to the end, and if you did, well done you. There's no prize, unfortunately, but hopefully you learned a thing or two. I tried to cover quite a lot in quite a short space of time, so obviously if I missed anything or if you've got any questions, feel free to drop a comment below or add me on Instagram and send me a DM, and I'll be happy to get back to you. If you like what you saw, obviously, do feel free to click the subscribe button. Plenty more film-related videos on the way. Thanks again, guys, and hopefully see you soon.